As the petition process continues at the Supreme Court, attention is slowly shifting to Kenyans and political parties. Religious leaders are condemning hate, anger, and discord that is being spread by Kenyans on social media. The Catholic bishops of Kenya particularly noting that Kenyans have changed tactics.
It is regrettable that while we thought Kenyans have grown out of their ethnic stereotypes and polarization, they have only moved the platform of the exchanges to a less conspicuous location. We remind them that they cannot hide from God and their conscience.
The National Council of Churches of Kenya echoing the same and further condemning President-elect Uhuru Kenyatta and the petitioner Raila Odinga for their heated exchange of words after the march for the election. They are asking Kenyans to live together harmoniously.
We call upon Kenyans to desist from spreading hate, anger and discord on social media. Instead, we urge that those active on social media use their energies and creativity to generate messages of peace and nationhood to lay a better foundation for the future.
The Catholic bishops, led by His Eminence John Cardinal Njue, have pleaded with politicians to desist from holding meetings that could turn provocative, urging them to give the Supreme Court time to exercise its responsibility.
We should understand that people are anxious, and therefore any attempts to engage them cannot be seen in good spirit. We wish to remind all politicians and political parties and coalitions that the foundation and purpose of political life is the development of the human person.
A message NCCK Secretary General Reverend Canon Peter Karanja emphasizes.
We urge all Kenyans to continue maintaining peace as we give time to the courts to process all the petitions that have been and may be lodged and make their rulings. We also urge the politicians and their supporters to honor their pledge to abide by the outcome and judgment of the Supreme and other courts when the rulings are issued.
Their calls comes after similar calls by Cohesion Commission and the Supreme Court, which ordered an end to all public debate on the issue by parties to the case. Reporting for JSO at 7, I'm Sam Gakunyi.